This is the brand new Guinness World Record largest ever elephant toothpaste foam experiment. In today's video, which is partially sponsored by LastPass, I'm gonna walk you through everything we had to go through to get to this point, as well as some really cool side discoveries we made in our hundreds of hours of testing along the way. The main ingredient for elephant's toothpaste is hydrogen peroxide. It's the same stuff you pour on a scrape to disinfect it. The thing is, the bonds that hold the hydrogen and oxygen together are pretty weak. So if we poured some of this in here and just left it for a while, it would keep releasing oxygen and eventually you'd be left with just water. However, if you add a catalyst like potassium iodide, you can make that slow process happen almost instantly. So that's cool, but we can make it way more impressive if we add one key ingredient, soap. So if we pour this in and then do everything else the same, now when the oxygen is released, the soap captures it, creating bubbles and foam. And then finally, if you do all that again, only now you add food coloring and use a flask that tapers like this, you can focus the expansion of foam so it looks maximum awesome. So in order to fill a pool with this stuff, I first got together with some friends and we spent literally hundreds of hours for a few weeks running experiments to calculate the best raw ingredient combinations in addition to brainstorming other cool things we might do with it. And so before we attempted to shatter the current world record, we had an end of summer party with my son and a bunch of family friends where we wanted to share with them the coolest side discoveries from our research. But first, in true end of summer fashion, we had to knock out some slip and slide kickball. I plan to kick things off by attacking them with an elephant toothpaste gun we made as revenge for when a bunch of these same kids ambushed me on a recent beach trip and then offered me some cookies, which were just six massive cockroaches. And I hate cockroaches. However, as part of our testing, we discovered the reaction is highly exothermic, which means it generates heat as a byproduct. If you watch it infrared, you'll see the temperature of the foam right after the reaction can reach almost 200 degrees Fahrenheit. So because I'm nice, I shelved my revenge plans and just demonstrated what would have been their fate and told them to sit and watch at a safe distance. And they listened. Sort of. And so now that we have their attention, it was showtime.
Three, two, one,
go!
This one's called the Melted Unicorn. You might recognize Bob Flugfelder here, aka Science Bob. He's been on Jimmy Kimmel Live 11 more times than I have, and I invited him out to join me for a very specific reason, which I will address in a bit. And so with the success of the science show behind us, it was now time for phase two. So we are here standing in an empty swimming pool about to try and break the world record for elephant's toothpaste. You want to tell the good people who owns the current world record, Bob?
I do.
You want to tell the good people who's about to not own the world record, Bob?
Pretty confident, aren't you?
No,
Mr.
I'm not.
Engineer.
But if everything goes well, we're hoping to quadruple the amount of the current record which you hold. I'm not sure how much of like the trees and neighborhood we're going to cover in the process. Only time will tell. And chemistry, which I don't understand, but we'll see what we can come up with. We wanted the foam to be safe to play in afterwards, so we used ordinary baking yeast as our catalyst. We could have bought yeast in big buckets, but it turned out it was cheaper to get them in 1 pound bags. The only downside to that is then you have to cut open 180 1 pound bags of yeast, but that's why we have Science Bob.
Come on out, they said. It'll be fun, they said.
This is an emergency tarp system. So if we did our math right, it shouldn't overflow. In the case that it does, we have these tarts here to contain all of the foam from not going everywhere in the yard. So we hope for the best, plan for the worst. We built these three frames for the tarps that would contain the catalyst yeast solution. So when it was time to fill the pool, we could just cut the tarps and it would pour out. The same way we cut the tarp when we added the bigger Orbeez.
I'm alive!
And Kevin. It's go time, baby. We're probably like 7 minutes out. Got a bunch of kids inside who are just raring to get out. The challenge here is this water's warm. We didn't build these containers big enough, so this will start rising. So it's sort of a race against the clock before it starts overflowing. We still have to add the soap, and then we have to add the food coloring. Oh, this looks terrifying as I stab this bloody thing. I think I'm about to get demonetized. Now we're adding the soap. This is what will actually make the bubbles. Soap isn't part of the reaction. Two more soap buckets. Oh, as you can see, that bucket's filling up real quick. So after a few final touches, we were ready to go. Now before we cut the tarps, I want to point out, I'm not a chemist. With the physics and engineering problem, I'm way more comfortable understanding the parameters and getting closer to the final solution off the bat. But chemistry is just little molecules I can't see, and it feels a lot like trial and error without any guarantee it will actually scale up predictably. This was feeling like the nightmare of the Jell-O pool all over again. To get to this point, we had ran over 150 tests, sometimes at great peril to that which we hold dear. And so once again, if this was a total failure, it wouldn't be from lack of effort. Having said all that, here she is.
2, 1, go!
So the good news is, we broke the record. The bad news is, we're kind of overachievers.
Uh-oh. It's coming up! The great tsunami! Hey, hold this.
Goodbye, camera.
Okay, stand back off the tarp.
Goodbye, camera.
Oh, we need to grab them. Stand back. Hold this up, Bob. Okay? Woo!
So while we pushed all the foam back into the pool, that gave it some time to cool down so we could actually touch it. The drone was super cool because not only did it make the foam look like an alien cocoon, but you could see it travel in infrared because it would expose the much hotter lower layers of foam as it flew around.
What do you guys think? Do you think this is gonna float?
No!
No? All right, here we go.
After all our tests, we perfected the chemistry for this stuff. So if you want to make a home version you can play with, check out Science Bob's website. I'll leave a link in the video description.
Bob, sorry you're looking at an obsolete piece of material there.
I had it for over a year.
You did have it for over a year, but all good things must come to an end.
Say I was mad, but darn, that was a lot of fun.
That was a lot of fun. And I have good news, because you are still the world record holder. I'm putting you on there with me, buddy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nerd hug.